This channel has been established for visually impaired people. For the visually impaired people, voice narration and a written expression are also provided for the hearing impaired. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel. In the days of fighting sale, a letter of marque and reprisal was a government license authorizing a person known as a privateer to attack and capture enemy vessels and bring them before admiralty courts for condemnation and sale. Cruising for prizes with a letter of marque was considered an honorable calling combining patriotism and profit, in contrast to unlicensed piracy, which was universally reviled. In addition to the term lettre de marque, the French sometimes used the term lettre de course for their letters of marque. Letter of marque was sometimes used to describe the vessel used. A letter of marque generally refers to a lumbering square-rigged cargo carrier that might pick up a prize if the opportunity arose. A privateer was a fast and weatherly fore and aft rigged vessel heavily armed and heavily crewed, intended exclusively for fighting. A letter of marque and reprisal would include permission to cross an international border to effect a reprisal, take some action against an attack or injury authorized by an issuing jurisdiction to conduct reprisal operations outside its borders. Contents 1. Etymology 11. Nomenclature History 2. Early History 3. Applying for, and legal effect of, letter of marque. 4. Adjudicating captures, invalid letter of marque, or illegal cruelty. 5. Abolition of privateering. 6. 20th century. 7. 21st century American reconsideration of letters of marque. 8. See also. 9. Notes. 10. References. Etymology. Old English miarque, from Germanic mark, boundary, boundary marker, from Proto-Indo-European merg, boundary, border, French, from Provençal marca, from marcar, seizes a pledge. Nomenclature history. According to the Oxford English Dictionary, the first recorded use of letters of marque and reprisal was in an English statute in 1354 during the reign of Edward III. The phrase referred to a license granted by a sovereign to a subject, authorizing him to make reprisals on the subjects of a hostile state for injuries alleged to have been done to him by the enemy's army. Early History. Drake viewing treasure taken from a Spanish ship, print courtesy New York Public Library. During the Middle Ages, armed private vessels enjoying their sovereign's tacit consent, if not always an explicit formal commission, regularly raided shipping of other nations, as in the case of Francis Drake's attacks on Spanish shipping, of which Elizabeth I, despite protestations of innocence, took a share. Grotius's 1604 seminal work on international law, De Iure Praede of the Law of Prize and Booty, was an advocate Advocate's brief defending Dutch raids on Spanish and Portuguese shipping. King Henry III of England first issued what later became known as privateering commissions in 1243. These early licenses were granted to specific individuals to seize the king's enemies at sea in return for splitting the proceeds between the privateers and the crown. The letter of marque and reprisal first arose in 1295, 50 years after wartime privateer licenses were first issued. According to Grotius, letters of marque and reprisal were akin to a private war, a concept alien to modern sensibilities but related to an age when the ocean was lawless and all merchant vessels sailed armed for self-defense. A reprisal involved seeking the sovereign's permission to exact private retribution against some foreign prince or subject. The earliest instance of a licensed reprisal recorded in England was in the year 1295 under the reign of Edward I. The notion of reprisal, and behind it that just war involved avenging a wrong, clung to the letter of marque until 1620 in England, in that to apply for one a shipowner had to submit to the Admiralty Court an estimate of actual losses. Licensing privateers during wartime became widespread in Europe by the 16th century, when most countries began to enact laws regulating the granting of letters of marque and reprisal. Business could be very profitable. During the 8 years of the American Revolutionary War, ships from the tiny island of Guernsey carrying letter of marque captured French and American vessels to the value of £900,000 and continued to operate during the Napoleonic Wars. Although privateering commissions and letters of marque were originally distinct legal concepts, such distinctions became purely technical by the 18th century. The United States Constitution, for instance, states that the Congress shall have power to grant letters of marque and reprisal, without separately addressing privateer commissions during the Napoleonic Wars and the War of 1812, and the American Independence War. It was common to distinguish verbally between privateers, also known as private ships of war, on the one hand, and armed merchantmen, which were referred to as letters of marque, on the other. Though both received the same commission, the Sir John Sherbrooke Halifax was a privateer, the Sir John Sherbrooke St. John was an armed merchantman the East India Company arranged for. letters of marque for its East Indiamen such as the Lord Nelson, not so that they could carry cannons to fend off warships, privateers, and pirates on their voyages to India and China, that they could do without permission, but so that, should they have the opportunity to take a prize, they could do so without being guilty of piracy. Similarly, the Earl of Mornington, an East India Company packet ship of only 6 guns, 2 carried a letter of marque in July 1793, the East Indiamen Royal Charlotte, Triton, and Worley participated in the capture of Pondicherry by maintaining a blockade of the port afterwards, as they were on their way to China. The same 3 East Indiamen participated in an action in the Straits of Malacca. They came upon a French frigate, with some 6 or 7 of her prizes, replenishing her water casks ashore. The 3 British vessels immediately gave chase. The frigate fled towards the Sunda Strait. The Indiamen were able to catch up with a number of the prizes, and, after a few cannon shots, were able to retake them had they not carried letters of marque. Such behavior might well have qualified as piracy. Similarly, on 10 November 1800 the East Indiaman Phoenix captured the French privateer General Malatic, under Jean-Marie Duterter, an action made legal by a letter of marque applying for, and legal effect of, letter of marque the body of Captain William Kidd hanging in a gibbet over the Thames, the result of confusion over whether Captain Kidd took prizes legally under a letter of marque, or illegally as a pirate. The procedure for issuing letters of marque and the issuing authority varied by time and circumstance in colonial America. For instance, colonial governors issued them in the name of the king during the American Revolution, first the state legislatures, then both the states and the Continental Congress, then, after ratification of the Constitution, Congress authorized and the president signed letters of marque a shipowner would send in an application stating the name, description, tonnage, and force armaments of the vessel, the name and residence of the owner, and the intended number of crew, and tendered a bond promising strict observance of the country's laws and treaties and of international laws and customs. The commission was granted to the vessel, not to its captain, often for a limited time or specified area, and stated the enemy upon whom attacks were permitted. For instance, during the Second Barbary War, President James Madison authorized the Salem, Mass. Brig Grand Turk to cruise against Algerine vessels, public or private, goods and effects of or belonging to the Dey of Algiers. Interestingly, this particular commission was never put to use, as it was issued the same day the treaty was signed ending the U.S. involvement in the war, July 3, 1815. A letter of marque and reprisal in effect converted a private merchant vessel into a naval auxiliary. A commissioned privateer enjoyed the protection and was subject to the obligations of the laws of war. If captured, the crew was entitled to honorable treatment as prisoners of war, while without the license they were deemed mere pirates at war with all the world. Criminals who were properly hanged for this reason, enterprising maritime raiders commonly took advantage of flag of convenience, letters of marque, shopping for cooperative governments to license and legitimize their depredations. French, Irishman Luke Ryan and his lieutenants in just over 2 years commanded 6 vessels under the flags of 3 different nations and on opposite sides in the same war. Likewise, the notorious Lafitte brothers in New Orleans cruised under letters of marque secured by bribery from corrupt officials of tenuous Central American governments, to cloak plunder with a thin veil of legality. Adjudicating captures, invalid letter of marque, or illegal cruelty. The letter of marque by its terms required privateers to bring captured vessels and their cargoes before admiralty courts of their own or allied countries for condemnation. Applying the rules and customs of prize law, the courts decided whether the letter of marque was valid and current, and whether the captured vessel or its cargo in fact belonged to the enemy. Not always easy, when flying false flags was common practice, and if so the prize and its cargo were condemned to be sold at auction with the proceeds divided among the privateer's owner and crew. A prize court's formal condemnation was required to transfer title, otherwise the vessel's previous owners might well reclaim her on her next voyage, and seek damages for the confiscated cargo. Often questions arose as to the legitimacy of the letter of marque in the case of divided sovereignty during civil wars. An English court, for instance, refused to recognize the letters of marque issued by rebellious Ireland under James II, and hanged 8 privateer captains as pirates. 79 years later during the American Civil War, the Union charged officers and crew of the Confederate privateer Savannah with piracy, calling their letter of marque invalid since the Union refused to acknowledge the breakaway Confederacy as a sovereign nation. The case resulted in a hung jury, and after Confederate President Jefferson Davis threatened to retaliate by hanging 1 Union officer for each executed Confederate privateer, the Union relented and thereafter treated Confederate privateersmen honorably as prisoners of war. Privateers were also required by the terms of their letters of marque to obey the laws of war, honor treaty obligations, avoid attacking neutrals, and in particular to treat captives as courteously and kindly as they safely could. If they failed to live up to their obligations, the Admiralty courts could, and did, revoke the letter of marque, refuse to award prize money, forfeit bonds, or even award tort personal injury damages against the privateer's officers and crew. Abolition of privateering. Nations often agreed by treaty to forego privateering, as England and France repeatedly did, starting with the diplomatic overtures of Edward III in 1324. Privateering nonetheless recurred in every war between them for the next 500 years. Benjamin Franklin had attempted to persuade the French to lead by example and stop issuing letters of marque to their corsairs, but the effort foundered when war loomed with Britain. Once again, the French Convention did forbid the practice, but it was reinstated after the Thermidorian reaction. In August 1795, on 26 September 1797, the Ministry of the Navy was authorized to sell small ships to private parties for this purpose. Finally, after the Congress of Paris at the end of the Crimean War, seven European nations signed the Paris Declaration of 1856 renouncing privateering, and 45 more eventually joined them, which in effect abolished privateering worldwide. The United States was not a signatory to that declaration despite the attempt to end privateering around the world. Nations continued issuing letters of marque in 1879 at the beginning of the War of the Pacific. Bolivia issued letters of marque to any vessels willing to fight for them. At the time, Bolivia was under threat from Chile's fleet but had no navy. 20th century. In December 1941 and the first months of 1942, Goodyear Commercial L-class blimp Resolute, operating out of Moffett Field in Sunnyvale, California, flew anti-submarine patrols as the civilian crew was armed with a rifle. Many thought this made the ship a privateer, and that she and sister commercial blimps were operated under letter of marque until the Navy took over operation without congressional authorization. The Navy would not have been able to legally issue any letters of marque. 21st century. American reconsideration of letters of marque. Article 1 of the United States Constitution lists issuing letters of marque and reprisal in Section 8 as one of the enumerated powers of Congress, alongside the power to tax and to declare war. However, since the American Civil War, the United States as a matter of policy has consistently followed the terms of the 1856 Paris Declaration forbidding the practice. The United States has not legally commissioned any privateers since 1815, although the status of submarine hunting Goodyear airships in the early days of World War II created significant confusion. Various accounts refer to airships Resolute and Volunteer as operating under a privateer status, but Congress never authorized a commission, nor did the President sign one. The issue of marque and reprisal was raised before Congress after the September 11 attacks and again on July 21, 2007, by Congressman Ron Paul. The attacks were defined as acts of air piracy, and the Marque and Reprisal Act of 2001 was introduced, which would have granted the President the authority to use letters of marque and reprisal against the specific terrorists. Instead of warring against a foreign state, the terrorists were compared to pirates in that they are difficult to fight by traditional military means. Paul on April 15, 2009, also advocated the use of letters of marque to address the issue of Somali pirates operating in the Gulf of Aden. However, the bills Paul introduced were not enacted into law. Former New Mexico governor and 2012-2016 libertarian presidential candidate Gary Johnson quipped in his Reddit AMA that letters of marque and reprisal would be an effective way to apprehend Lord's Resistance Army leader Joseph Kony instead of using U.S. troops. See also Commerce raiding Confederate privateer hired armed vessels. No purchase, no pay prize law. Punitive expedition reprisal. Jean-Bart Enos Collins. Miguel Enriquez. René Duguay. Truand Amboise. Louis Garneret. Alexander Godfrey. Jean Lafitte. Pierre Lafitte. Henry Morgan. Robert Surcoff. Joseph Potier. Notes. Carrot Upton's Maritime Warfare and Prize. pp. 172-171, 176. Discussing the history of letters of marque and reprisal. Upton is considered the foremost 19th-century American scholar on prize law. Carrot Donald Petrie. The Prize Game. p. 4. Noting cumbrous square-rigged cargo carriers often secured letters of marque just in case. Unfusingly, such vessels were themselves called letters of marque. See also Jeffrey Footner, Tidewater Triumph, pp. Carrot. From the Digital Gallery, New York Public Library. Drake, Treasure. Carrot. Lord Russell, The French Corsairs. p. 10. Discussing history of private plundering ventures. Carrot. Grotius, De Iure Prede Commentarius. Commentary on the Law of Prize and Booty. 216-182. Carnegie Endowment. Translation of Grotius's commentaries. The 12th chapter later became the basis of the noted Mare Liberum. Freedom of the Seas Principle. Carrot. Francis R. Stark, The Abolition of Privateering and the Declaration Convention of Paris, in Studies in History, Economics and Public Law 221, 270-71 Faculty of Political Sci of Columbia Univ EDS, Columbia University, 1897 Carat Stark at 272 Carat Grotius, De Iure Praede Commentarius Commentary on the Law of Prize and Booty, pp. 62 stating the power to wage war privately resides in the individual, and the power to wage war publicly resides in the state. Carat Eastman, Famous Privateers of New England, p. 1 citing Edward I 1295 Reprisal Commission. Carat Lord Russell, The French Corsairs, p. 12 discussing early practice in England. Carat Eastman, Famous Privateers of New England, p. 1 recounting early letters of marque issued in contest between Spain and her revolted Low Countries in 1569. Carat Lord Russell, The French Corsairs, p. 11 discussing history of letters of marque. In France, the first recorded use of letters of marque and reprisal was 1681. Carat Upton's Maritime Warfare and Prize, p. 176 discussing the history of letters of marque and reprisal. Carat Henry, Roy, The Reclamation of the Bray du Valais 1806-2006. The line Carat Petrie, The Prize Game, p. 68 discussing Luke Ryan. In these 2 years they took 140 recorded prizes. Carat William Davis, The Pirates Laffite, p. Diplomatic efforts to ban privateering between France and England. Carat Lord Russell, French Privateering, p. 34-35 discussing Franklin's efforts to persuade the French Legislative Assembly to ban privateering. Carat Grainier, Hubert 1998 Histoire des Marins Français 1789-1815 illustrations by Alain Cousmarines editions p. References. William C. Davis, The Pirates Laffite, The Treacherous World of the Corsairs of the Gulf. Orlando, Florida, Harcourt, 2005. Ralph M. Eastman, Some Famous Privateers of New England, Boston, privately printed by State Street Trust Company, 1927. Jeffrey Footner, Tidewater Triumph, The Development and Worldwide Success of the Chesapeake Bay Pilot Schooner Mystic, Conn, Mystic Seaport Museum, 1998. Grotius, De Iure Praede Commentarius Commentary on the Law of Prize and Booty. Oxford, Clarendon Press, 1950. Donald Petrie, The Prize Game, Lawful Looting on the High Seas in the Days of Fighting Sail. Annapolis, M.D., Naval Institute Press, 1999. William Morrison Robinson, Jr., The Confederate Privateers. Columbia, S.C., University of South Carolina Press, 1928. Lord Russell of Liverpool, The French Corsairs. London, Robert Hale, 2001. Carl E. Swanson, Predators and Prizes, American Privateering and Imperial Warfare, 1739-1748. Columbia, S.C., U. South Carolina Press, 1991. Francis Upton, Upton's Maritime Warfare and Prize. New York, John Voorhees Law Bookseller and Publisher, 1863. V.E. Piracy Periods Ancient Mediterranean Golden Age Republic of Pirates Libertatia 21st Century Types of Pirate Privateers Buccaneers Corsairs Cindy Corsairs Timber Pirate River Pirate Brethren of the Coast Barbary Pirates Moro Pirates Woku Vikings Ushkwinix Narantines Cilician Pirates Confederate Privateer Baltic Slavic Pirates Uskokes Cossack Pirates Sea Beggars Sea Dogs Filibusters Areas Piracy in the Caribbean Piracy on Lake Nicaragua Piracy in the British Virgin Islands Piracy in the Strait of Malacca Piracy off the coast of Somalia Piracy in the Sulu Sea Piracy on Falcon Lake Pirates of the South China Coast Anglo-Turkish Piracy Port Royal Tortuga St. Malo Barbary Coast Lundi Lagos Salé Spanish Main Piracy in the Gulf of Guinea Piracy in Indonesia Barataria Bay Piracy in the Persian Gulf Noted Pirates Bartholomew Roberts Hendrick Lucifer Haradine Barbarossa Blackbeard Stade Bonnet Anne Bonnie Absher Boya Lawrence de Groff Michel de Grammont Calico Jack Alexander Exquemelin William Kidd Edward Lowe Redbeard William Dampier Black Caesar Henri Caesar Roberto Cafresi Jean Lafitte Henry Morgan Lawrence Prince Francois Lolonais Henry Strangways Charles Gibbs Benito de Soto Diabolito Pedro Gilbert Mansell Alcantara Hippolyte Bouchard Samuel Hall Lord Nathaniel Gordon Albert W. Hicks Eli Boggs Bully Hayes Rama Ibn Habir Al-Jalahima Louis Michel Ori Shirahama Kenki John Newland Moffat Joseph Baker Joseph Barse Jorgen Jorgensen Vincenzo Gambi Dominique U. Pierre Lafitte John Hawkins Peter Easton Nicholas Van Horn Moses Cohen Enriquez Pete Peterzoon Hein Charlotte de Berry Samuel Bellamy Benjamin Hornigold Samuel Mason Henry Every Roche Brasiliano Gun Ning Liang Daoming Wang Ji Limahong Jung Jilong Jung Jing Kai Qian Chung Po Sai Ching Shi Shap Ing Sai Kui A Pu Lai Choi San Fuma Kotaro Olivier Levisser. Categories: Piracy, Pirates. By nationality: Barbary Pirates, Female Pirates, Years in Piracy, Fictional Pirates, Pirate Ships Adventure, Galley Fancy, Ganj Isawai, Queen Anne's Revenge, Kada Merchant, Saladin Waida, Galley Marquis of Havana, Ambrose Light, York Pirate Hunters, Pedro Menendez de Avilés, Angelo Emo, Richard Avery, Hornsby Robert, Maynard Shaliner, Ogle Pompey, Woods Rogers, David Porter, James Brooke, Miguel Enriquez, Privateer, Pirate Battles and Incidents, Jajing Woku Raids, Turkish Abductions, Chepo Expedition, Battle of Mandab Strait, Blockade of Charleston, Battle of Cape Fear River, Battle of Ocracoke Inlet, Capture of the William Sack of Campeche, Attack on Veracruz, Raid on Cartagena, Battle of Cape Lopez, Capture of the Fancy Persian Gulf Campaign, Battle of New Orleans, Anti-Piracy in the Aegean, Anti-Piracy in the West Indies, Capture of the Bravo, Action of 9 November 1822, Capture of the El Mosquito, Battle of Douro Passage, Falklands Expedition, Great Lakes Patrol, Pirate Attacks in Borneo, Belongingui Expedition, Battle of Taisami, Battle of Tonkin River, Battle of Nam Quan, Battle of Tai Ho Bay, Battle of the Leotung Antelope Incident, North Star Affair, Battle off Muka Salvador, Pirates, Battle of Boca Ticapan, Capture of the Ambrose Light, Irene Incident 1985, Lahad Datu Ambush, Operation Enduring Freedom, WA, Action of 18 March 2006, Action of 3 June 2007, Action of 28 October 2007, Dai Hong Dan Incident, Operation Atalanta, Kare Dia IV Incident, Action of 11 November 2008, Action of 9 April 2009, Maersk Alabama Hijacking, Operation Ocean Shield, Action of 23 March 2010, Action of 1 April 2010, Action of 30 March 2010, Action of 5 April 2010, Megavolts Moscow University Hijacking, Operation Dawn of Gulf of Aden, Operation Dawn 8, Gulf of Aden Beluga Nomination Incident, Battle off Minicoy Island, Quest Incident, Mount Zafira Hijacking, Mount Orkham Harmony Hijacking, Slave Trade, African Slave Trade, Atlantic Slave Trade, Arab Slave Trade, Barbary Slave Trade, Blockade of Africa, African Slave Trade Patrol, Capture of the Providencia, Capture of the Presidente, Capture of the El Almirante, Capture of the Marinerito, Capture of the Velos Passagera, Capture of the Brillante Amistad Incident, Capture of the Emanuela, Fictional Pirates Tom Ireton, Barb Rouge, Hector Barbosa, Captain Blood, Captain Crook, Captain Flint, Jose Gaspar, Captain Hook, Don Carnage, Monkey D. Luffy, Roronoa, Zoro, One Piece, Captain Nemo, Captain Pugwash, Red Rackham, Captain Sabretooth, Captain Stingery, Sandokan, Long John Silver, Jack Sparrow. Miscellaneous: Truce of Ratisbon, Piracy Act 1698, Piracy Act 1717, Piracy Act 1837, Paris Declaration Respecting Maritime Law, Child Pirate, Golden Age of Piracy, Jolly Roger, Walking the Plank, Treasure Map, Buried Treasure, Pirate Booty, No Purchase, No Pay, Marooning, Pirate Code, Pirate Utopia, Vittel Brothers, Pirate Round, Libertatia, Sack of Baltimore, A General History of the Pirates, Mutiny, Pegleg, Eyepatch, Letter of Mark, Davy Jones, Locker, Air Pirate, Space Pirate, Lists Pirates, Privateers, Timeline of Piracy, Pirate Films, Women in Piracy, Fictional Pirates, Pirates in Popular Culture, List of Ships Attacked by Somali Pirates, Literature, Treasure Island, Facing the Flag on Stranger Tides, Castaways of the Flying Dutchman, The Angels Command, Voyage of Slaves, Pirate Latitudes.